Today is Monday, April 29th.
Now over to Jamie with some more announcements.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give," by Winston Churchill. Lunch for today is buffalo roasted chicken and no hot combo. And lunch for tomorrow is buckskin burger and a hot combo of chicken filet sandwich. Now over to your weather report.
Three, two, one. Hey, what's up, you guys? Today is going to be bright and sunny.
With a high of 62 and a low of 52.
And tomorrow's going to be thunderstorming, so bring your umbrellas.
With a high of 75 and a low of 54.
A low of what, Beth?
54.
A low of 54. Now for headline news.
Thanks, Weather Girls. Despite playing football at a low-profile Division II school, Ballantyne was drafted by the NFL's New York Giants on Saturday night, the culmination of years of hard work on and off the field. "I've been waiting on this opportunity for a lifetime, really," he told Giants coach Pat Shermer after hearing the news. But in a tragic turn just hours later, Ballantyne was injured in an off-campus shooting in Topeka, Kansas, that killed one of his Washburn University teammates. Dwayne Simmons, a 23-year-old defensive back, was killed in the shooting, said Washburn president Jerry Farley. Farley said Ballantyne, who was drafted in the sixth round by the Giants, is expected to make a full recovery. Both Dwayne and Corey have been great examples and representatives of the football team and of Washburn University in general, Farley said in a statement. "This was a terrible way to end a day which should have been a day of celebration and a day to look forward to Dwayne's upcoming year at Washburn and the beginning of Corey's professional career." The Giants said they are aware of the situation and are gathering information. "We have spoken to Corey, and he is recovering in the hospital. Our thoughts are with the Dwayne Simmons family, friends, and teammates, and the rest of the Washburn community," the team said. I'm Sophia Steed, reporting.
Do you want to be a part of the National Honor Society next year? Stop by Mr. Schley's class today to pick up an application. You must have each requirement completed on the application by Wednesday, May 1st. If you are a great leader, volunteer, and care about others, you are a great candidate for NHS. You would have received an email if you are eligible with a GPA 3.5 or higher. If you have any questions, email Mr. Schley. Thanks, Evie. Attention TSA students who plan on going to the national conference in June. Please let Mr. P know before Tuesday, April 30th, what events you would like to participate in at the conference. You may see Mr. P in room 158 or send an email. Thanks. Now over to Money with Mead.
Hi, CB. It's Mrs. Mead with Money with Mead. Well, it's coming down to the end as of today. There's only 23 school days left, and yes, seniors, I know yours is shorter, it's like 19 or 20. So I'm here to tell you a couple of things. Number one, Senior Awards Night is May 16th, and it starts at 7 p.m. We actually have some kind of desserts and things and check-ins, so we always say that you should be here by like 6:30. But you're probably thinking, well, how do I know if I come or not? Within the next week, week and a half, you'll be getting a letter, and in that letter it will state if you've been invited or not to Senior Awards Night. And then you have to respond to Mrs. Marilyn Martin in the office and tell them how many people will be attending with you. Now, even if you don't get a letter, you're more than welcome to receive and cheer on your classmates. And like I said, it's May 16th at 7 p.m. The only scholarship still out there for CV is the CVEA scholarship, and that's due this Friday, May 2nd. I think that's this Friday, it might be Thursday. Anyway, and that, remember, is given at graduation, so that is not part of Senior Awards Night. Other than that, I have one last thing, CV. Unified Track, this Wednesday, 4 o'clock, back in the stadium. You get to hear my voice. I'm announcing, so come out and support the Unified Track team. I hope to see you there. Bye.
Are you interested in health, wellness, and physical activity? If so, the Health Council Club might be for you. If interested in joining the Health Council next year, please pick up an application in Dr. Facera's classroom, room 171 near the Royal Gymnasium. You must be able to make meetings during flex throughout the school year. Applications are due by Friday, May 10th. SATs are on Saturday, May 4th. If you're registered to take them, please be here at CVHS by 7:30 a.m. Remember your photo ID and SAT admissions ticket. Leave your phone at home or in the safest place in your car, and bring your own calculator, pencils, and erasers.
Attention AP students! You must attend one of the following sessions to complete the demographic information for your upcoming AP tests. Wednesday, May 1st during lunches, Thursday, May 2nd during Block 2, Thursday, May 2nd during Block 3. Please set a reminder on your phone and be prompt. Remember, you must attend one of these sessions. Check your email for the full details. Now over to CV Sports.
Life's like a road that you travel on. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand. Sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate.
An away baseball game against Solanco at 4:15. Dismissal at 2.
There's an away girls lacrosse game against Penn Manor at 7.
There's a home softball game at 4:15 against Solanco. It is senior day for the softball team.
There's a home track and field meet against McCaskey at 6. Senior night recognition starts at 5.
There's a home volleyball game against Reading at 7.
Come out and support the Bucks.
Now for sports highlights.
A marquee matchup, two heavyweights who feel they have what it takes to win the NBA championship. Harden hearing the boos from the crowd, leans in. They let it go, and Harden flips it up and in for his first bucket. Durant, big height advantage on Gordon, drives, gets in the lane, shot, bounces around, and drops in. Alfonso McKinney has checked in for the first time. Klay Thompson sits down. Thompson hit his first and only shot as a 5-point Golden State lead. Durant on Harden. Harden for three. That's his fourth three-pointer. He's 4 for 12. That's what Livingston is doing. He's pointing to Iguodala. Go to him. He's got house on him. Step back is good. Lead is 6, 22 for Durant. Chris Paul knocks it down. Chris Paul with a three-point. Harden fires a shot. No, he stepped out of bounds. Golden State ball with 109 to play. 5-point game. Harden to the basket, lays it up, and banks it home with a foul. And Thompson picks up his fourth foul. Curry crossover, three-pointer, bang! Just over 24 seconds remaining. Harden drives, gets inside, and throws it down. Quick bucket. And that cuts it to three with 21.3 remaining. Here comes Harden. Shot clock off. Harden steps back, puts up a three. Won't go. Rebound goes to Paul. Ball knocked loose, and Gordon was out of bounds when he had it. Golden State ball and a technical foul. Paul's just been thrown out of the game. With 4.4 remaining. That will do it. A pulsating win for Golden State, a heartbreaking loss for Houston here in game one.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCVH, I am Bethany alongside
Karis.
And this is CV Today. Have a marvel Monday.
Into a fishbowl, back into the deep blue, like you're on a blurred out video. Always got the best view.